We're getting ready for a second game. That first one was a real nail biter. If you fell offline or something happened, there was a interference call, I guess is the best way of putting it, so that we can describe it online. But we had a line shot go between a player's leg and hit one of the spotters. And the final call on it was that the spotter was interfered with the flight of the ball, that it was a dead ball. And that's what the call finally came out to be. It changed from a run to an out, back to a run. No, an out to a run, back to an out, and then a dead ball and a new bat. And that's when Taiwan tied it up and went into an extra inning, seventh inning. Austin didn't make any runs. It got down to one more out to go to an eighth inning, and Leo popped another run. So we're having a coin flip. And they're going back to their benches, and I didn't get to see who got what.
Again, this is Tim Hittner and Richie Flores and Steve Guerra chiming in to give you guys the play-by-play and color and updates on NBBA for the second game. Actually, this is going to be Taiwan's third game of the day.
Oh my gosh, Richie, three games in a day? That's like the round robin in the first
it's
day.
Tuesday morning.
Yeah, they go three games the first day, three games the last day. That's got to be brutal.
Yep.
They're over there massaging and stretching their people and trying to stay loose for this game.
You know, it might be their 12th game of the, maybe their 11th or 12th game of the week.
I tell you what,
Taiwan only played two games yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
So,
the 11th game.
Yep.
11th game of the week. So, anyway, they've crawled and clawed and scratched through the bottom brackets all the way back to the top, and then
the rule book fell in their favor there. So
they could have walked away, but they've learned to let's double check that rule, and they did. They put their official protest up, and they looked at it one more time. One of the rules come. Somebody found one of the rules. It fell in their favor, and now we're going into a second game.
As you remember, in 2012, this same situation happened, and here we go.
Yeah, I don't know who won the coin flip, sir. Joe, who won the coin flip?
That is an excellent question.
Oh, I thought you was out there. I'm sorry.
I was a little bit out of distance.
That's all right. It's all right, Joe. Already did it.
So who's up first?
Okay, they're rotating since it's a.
It's just an automatic switch.
Okay.
Yep.
Austin will be home.
Austin will be home field, and we're going to start another game. They're starting to line up for mass checks and everything. I think Austin's done whooped it up.
Yep. We're going to hear the Taiwan cheer and. We're gonna go again.
I tell you what, I always have a little lull in my life after the beat ball's over. I remember the days when beat ball would start up and we'd drive up and down I-35, play in Kansas, we play in Topeka, we play in Wichita. We'd drive down I-35, we play in Dallas, Fort Worth areas. Oh, those are the days now. All summer long we'd be playing beat ball and then go to the World Series. Spectators are starting to show back up.
Yes, sir. We still got pretty packed house here. These nice weather's keeping people around. We had to move back our banquet, which usually starts at 7. But tonight will most likely start at 9.
Thank you.
here, Tim.
How's it going, Richie?
Hey, man. Looks like you're back. Nice to meet
you. Look.
Yeah, get some shirts.
Everybody, what World Series wouldn't be complete without purchasing the NBPA wristband and or t-shirt? We're going like hotcakes. Get over there and get them now.
I'm like right to your left. If I go under this tent, I mean, you might be able to squeeze in here.
Yeah, because
we have two dogs in front,
yeah, so be careful. But if, this is where we're at. So if you want to just find a good spot, it's not the most comfortable, but
you could slide that that amplifier out just a little bit.
This one? This
yeah.
Thing?
Yeah, slide it. Just slide it out just a little bit.
Makes it.
And put it out in front. Oh, it's attached to something.
No, it's just like. What's up?
We didn't say Jordy gets in under the goddamn tent.
No, yeah, no Jordy.
Oh, gee, money. The girl and the dog can, but.
I'm here with the sunscreen. Sam.
You can sit right behind me.
He said he,
yeah,
he got,
you got
the
my chair.
The sun's still shining.
You want my chair?
That's later.
I'm not done. I need it on my back. You're going to let me know. Oh, really?
Yeah, it's like, you got to get under it. It's like pretty low. There you are. Oh, that's your face.
What are you trying to do? Poke an eye out?
Sorry.
Still hurts. See there?
All right, they're base checking here. Hey. So yeah, that's the other thing. You gotta be probably extra quiet, guys.
Yeah, because this, we're live. Everything you say is going out over the internet.
Yeah. So again, we're back here at Truth and Grace, or Grace and Truth Park, for the third game of Taiwan for the day, but the second game against the Austin Blackhawks. Right now, they're 1-1 in the series against each other, so they're going to have one more matchup here to determine who is going to go home with this championship after this controversial ending. Very dramatic. But exciting experience.
Put her over there to your right. Jocelyn over there. Scooch her over there to your right. No, no. Crystal. Put Crystal over there so she can have her dog get in the shade. Because there's more shade over there. Yeah.
This way.
Hey. That poor baby don't need to be sitting in the sun.
I want to hit a ball. I want to get it.
Sit on that.
Here it comes. We'll get an abbreviated cheer this time.
Yeah, I didn't do the whole singing thing.
Didn't make me want to dance. But I think
is that better, Crystal?
Yeah.
I want this game over.
Yeah, we're live, baby.
Excellent. My man, Richie, Timmy.
He's sound bombing us.
Yes.
I'm here, baby.
Audio bomb.
Audio bomb, not a photo bomb.
I'm the Performing Arts Division President. I got to do what I got to do, you know? We're here with the NBBA, baby. 2015 World Series.
I don't know what the holdup is. They said we were going to start and then...
Yeah, you know. Everybody's got to get set up.
Got a couple of umps. All right. There's some umps there.
Okay.
There's teams there, teams there. There's balls there. I think it's time to play a game.
I am ready for that. I am ready to watch. It's definitely cut into my nap / laundry time before banquet, but that's all right. We'll figure out all that afterwards.
Later, baby.
All right.
Mike.
What? Really?
Yeah. Want some jerky, Mike?
Water.
Want some jerky?
I'm gonna give it up to this sports complex. They got a scoreboard out. I don't remember that ever happening during a game. We do have about half the league. Half the league is sighted, folks, so they appreciate the scoreboard, I'm sure.
He's from
maybe he belongs to Wayne Simpson.
He's licking his front arms a lot.
Pacifico.
He's getting raw.
Hey, Mike. You see my ex-wife over there? An awesome lady.
I don't see her either.
Yeah, maybe get Rusty or one of the kids to come get the dog or something.
The kids aren't there
anymore.
We couldn't have licked it all off in just the last 15 minutes.
Hey, Holly.
Oh, I'll do better. I'll do better. I won't peek no more. Somebody say he's licking the hide off his arms.
No, he's been doing that. It's out.
Okay.
You want me to take him out?
No, you, I mean, finally about it.
Somebody was just saying.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, no, Wayne knows. He has a deal now.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Stay out of trouble now.
Somebody need headphones?
Okay. All right, I got my seeing glasses on.
Okay.
I got my bifocals. I'll try to read these names again.
I wonder if they're just going to run it all the way through. Are there any substitutions? We haven't been told that.
We haven't been told anything except that we're supposed to start.
These are two strong teams. They're a serious day out here.
Hey, Rusty.
4:33.
Hey, Holly. Can you find out if there's any changes to the starting
lineup? Where's
he
at? Darius will DF.
Is Darius DF? No, not him.
Okay, they're just going to roll with it.
Yeah, so it goes Loopy, Mike, Axel,
yeah.
Eric, and Brandon.
Right. Oh, Brandon is moved to sixth.
Mike.
Thank you.
Lupe, Mike.
Zach.
Axel.
Eric.
Brandon. I remember that lineup. That was last year's lineup, pretty much. I'm gonna bring it up, bring it back, roll it around. Loopy wants some revenge, I'm sure.
It is an open mic, so if you do talk, it'll pick it up no matter what happens.
Yeah.
It's
kind of like... Thank you, everyone, for staying around for our second game.
From the radio.
We'll be starting momentarily.
Yeah, it's condenser, so it's...
Gotcha.
okay. The crowd seems to be quieting down, coming back from concessions. The teams are ready.
We have two of them on the line. Inspections for their blindfolds are ready.
So we're just a matter of minutes now from getting started with the second game between the Taiwan Home Run and the Austin Blackhawks for the championship, the Beat Baseball World Series 2015.
All right, I finished my eats.
Good.
We're ready to go.
Yep, got a good lunch, got a nice tea, got some water. Hopefully I don't lose my whole voice, but definitely apologize to you guys in advance for any scratchiness. It's just been a very fun week out here, but you know, that dirt, that dust, that wind can really get those allergies going. But love being here. Appreciate the opportunity to do the color with Tim Hittner. And watch another game of Beat Baseball. It ain't over yet.
You're a colorful fella.
So we got any patch games going on this time, Tim?
I think it patched. I don't think so. You know, and in the past, I've just told people if we think somebody's doing something like that, he can only run so fast to the base. You know, I mean, is the base gonna move? If he, you know, basically, so. Just put him out.
Right.
Just keep putting him out. That was our thing was, just don't, you know, and if.
Keep making plays.
Yep. Yeah. I think everybody's just wearing their blindfold.
If he's in the field, his field of view got to be really small. And you know, just hit it away from him. So that was always our thought process, was just to, you know, try not to get the controversy going in the first place. Just put your best game out there and go.
And make plays.
Make plays.
Make plays.
You know, don't make excuses. Make plays.
Indeed.
And that's what we did. You know?
That's the way to be.
Yeah.
Hey, Mike.
Again, Mike Woodard is the plate umpire, along with another team of umpires that have worked all week calling games, judging the base runs, judging the field plays.
There's Kevin out there. He's out in the middle of the field. He's walking around, focusing, trying to get his head around the game, man. You know, he's got.
Kevin has been pitching since he was 16 years old. He's gonna be fine. It's a walk in the park. It's just a matter of what Taiwan brings. They're tired, man.
Yeah, the wind's dying down a little bit. And now that I mention it, it starts picking up again, but it doesn't feel like the gusts are as gusty as they was earlier, so to speak. They're not popping the net on top as much, and it's just a nice, cool breeze and a great day for another game, as far as I'm concerned.
Yes, sir. We'll do our best to try to get a few more folks in this call, particularly Blake Boudreau, second vice president of the MBBA and also the PR director.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. We got to get Blake in here, sure enough.
I did talk to him, so he'll be out here. He plays Bayou City
Heat. He got injured, though, didn't he? He
got a bum knee.
He got a bum knee, but he said no, nothing's torn, nothing's broken, so no surgeries. So it's just a matter of it losing the swell and rest.
Two strong teams here.
Oh, yeah. These are two titans. You know, these are two titans right here going at it.
As I have a few guide dogs around me here, I just want to give it up to Doggy Daycare again. MBBA always has that for our dog users who are blind and choose that travel tool. It's just really cool that every year we're able to give them some good attention and good care. appreciate the dog dedication.
And you know, a working dog deserves better. I don't say better, but they deserve the best care they can be given. A working dog is so, they depend on a working dog so much that when it comes to something like this, they deserve to be taken care of like they're kings, you know, in my opinion.
Yeah. The biggest deal is, you know, we play this game, we don't really use canes, and so it's probably just safer for the dogs for them to be, you know, in a pen that, or in a place that's comfortable for them, instead of a bunch of blind dudes running around a bench and trying to find their gloves, or they get stepped on by accident, different things. So I really,
the people that run that are trained for that kind of activity. They know what the needs are, and
right,
things of that nature. Just got to try to give it up to them for being out here as much as they were out here.
We usually partner up with, you know, pet care facilities in the city, and in every series. So I think we're almost getting ready. I hear Kevin yelling for one of the players to get ready and get it done.
Don't bother me. But I here, if you'll throw that away, because that's what caught, that will get stirred up. I can guarantee you that's what it is. I'd take it out of my bag.
Such an exciting game, man. To be here, be in Rochester, New York. This is a beautiful day, beautiful game, beautiful people. Amazing. NBBA, baby.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Steve, you want throughout the game start maybe naming off some of the placements, sharing that with some folks? You probably know them by heart. I know Lone Star got 13th. That's all I know and care about right now.
Well, let's tell you. Third place went to RHI Extreme. Fourth was Houston.
Okay.
Iowa City Heat. Fifth was Boston. No, I'm sorry. Yeah, fifth was Boston.
Wow.
Sixth was Colorado. Seventh was Chicago Comets.
Wow.
Eighth was Indianapolis Thunder. Ninth was Southwest Slammers. Mm. Tenth was Minnesota. 11th was Taiwan Lightning. 12th was Indy Knights, which is a significant jump. They only started this year. They came in at 19th and ended up at 12th. 13th was Lone Star. 14th was Atlanta. And I'll have to get back to you with the rest of them.
Yeah, it's a good rundown. That's really cool to see Boston moving up them ranks, man.
Yeah.
They're coming to play it every year. It seems like they make some noise in that top eight.
Yeah.
Played Boston a long time ago, man, and they've come a long, long way.
Yeah, they're rowdy bunch, but they get it done. You know, it's. I used to coach. I said, you know, I see you scoring a lot of runs. I said, but you're giving up a lot of runs. Why? He goes, well, that's the whole point of using your bench.
Right.
Well, I guess so.
Right.
And I'll give you the rest of those breakdowns in a little while when I.
Yeah. Just kind of confirm them. Yeah, no problem.
I tell you, this year we've had three international teams in. We had Canada in and the two Taiwanese team. And Canada says they're going to go back and talk to another group of people that have a blind sports situation going on and ask if they want to come. They're going to go back and stir up some more interest, and they're going to bring two teams next year if they can.
Wow. Yeah, they had a great time. I mean, and very nice, nice dudes, man, like super nice. Really excited. A lot of them were blind ice hockey players, which is pretty cool.
That's what I understand.
I talked to them a little bit about that game. I know they have a lot of variations of it in different areas, but really cool that last year we had the Total Access, I believe. Which featured beat baseball, and it's a Canadian adaptive sports video program. Oh, and our dogs are moving around here.
Yeah,
getting excited.
They have to. They're playing.
Okay.
That's they're playing. Somebody gonna have to take. You know, somebody gonna have to help us out over here.
Holly.
They're playing.
Toby.
plan is to get started soon, guys.
Yeah, we're trying to fill here.
Glad you guys are hanging in.
They're
I hear a beat ball.
I heard him test the bases. I hear a ball beep. You tried. They got cooled off and got frisky.
Yes. I'm sorry. I'm going to lift this up for just a second to get the release. Okay, got it. Thank you.
You know, Kevin Simpson and Kenny Whittier have been the pitcher-catcher combo since 97.
All right, I see the one umpire motion to another umpire, get him in the field.
Won multiple pitcher-catcher awards, and this is going to be one of their crowning moments here to see if they can pull this off. Again, Austin's only played about 8 games this whole week, and you know, as we're Taiwan's probably on their 11th game here. They're tired, but they didn't come all this way to go home this way, or to go home without the title. They're gonna scratch it out here.
Too hungry, Jake. He's got hungry.
They took the two dogs from in front of the table. If you guys want to move out in front of the table. Somebody have to help you get there, but it's a lot of shade up in front.
Oh, don't worry. I'm happy to help these two young ladies over here.
Oh, I know you are. Nothing wrong with it. I said nothing wrong with it.
Oh, here comes the dance.
Here we go. Let's dance, baby. Let's dance.
Taiwanese dance. Tear. It's really cool that Taiwan also reaches out to the local community, and there's a lot of the Taiwanese community here from locally here that come watch them and provide funding and support. Go to dinner sometimes at some of their churches and homes.
Leo's taking the field.
We're about to start the game at approximately 4:50.
Starting the game at 4:50.
Oh, man.
And Taiwan will be batting first, so it'll probably be 55. Number 55.
All right, Leo's rosin it up a little bit on his hands so the ball don't slip.
Am I going to be in your way, guys? I'm back over here where I was before.
I don't think so. Not
sure.
Yeah, not significantly.
Is that good?
How about you, Rich? Is he in your
way? I'm fine, sir. You can totally block my way. No.
And you won't be offended.
I won't be offended. You might just provide me more shade.
Let's play some ball, guys.
Okay. And we're back. Hawks out on D. They're going to be the home team in this round. 6 innings.
All right, well, top of the order, number 55. Wen Shen-Chu. Hopefully that's right. All right, Leo's got the ball up. He's ready to go. It's a hit right in the three zone on the first base side. It's a hard hit.
He's up.
Got it, third guy. He got out there quick. He hit it hard. He got out there quick.
Right field must have been Zach Arambula.
It was Zach. Yeah. Zach got it up.
Back in the right.
What did we say in the beginning? Make plays, make plays. Both teams are here to do that today.
Right, the energy is up on both sides here.
Now we're up to the number 9 batter, the DH.
First
the Taiwanese team.
Number 9.
That's right. That's the way Leo likes to start them off. You get that first
I'm
pitch.
I'm the left fielder, left fielder.
He's the one that made the 14th run. He's the number 9.
What happened on the left fielder?
Yeah, the out.
Oh, he the left fielder. Okay, number 9 made the 14th run. Right. Did he make the controversial run?
Yes, this is number 9.
Play it for a little while.
No.
Alright, here we go. Chain K. Chin. King Che Chin.
And he's their DH, so.
DH, number 9. I do know that. He's checking his distance on the play, making sure he's lined up right, stretching a little bit. Got a little ritual. Stretch. He'll have to take that ball, too, so we'll have to wait for the ball to pass.
Yep, he does take that ball, so. I think they said he was recently blinded. You remember what Dave Wanchek said.
Delay a game, strike one.
Delay a game. Wow, never seen that either.
Wow.
We're enforcing that 30 seconds.
Absolutely.
You have 30 seconds.
Kevin, go one. Here we go.
Wow.
Swinging.
There's a pass.
101.
Prove me wrong.
No, he takes his ball.
He's they're checking there. You know, they want to move these games along.
Ooh.
Oh, nice
grounder
up the
towards Eric. Mike.
Got it.
Middle. Mike
Finn.
Mike Finn got in front of it, stopped that ball.
On the ground,
it's all
though.
About intersecting. Yep. Like I told you before, you got to get in front of a rolling ball if you want to make it out in this level.
Yeah, a rare hit on the ground from number 9. He usually doesn't do that.
This is number 35. Now, 35, once again, we was talking
now
about.
Now batting number 35.
We was talking before, number 35 had a home run, we were told.
Yep.
In one of the earlier games.
Which counts for 2 runs.
It doesn't.
It does not.
I was told, I thought the same thing. It was told different.
Huh.
So, Kung Tai Koo, I think it is. K-U is the last.
Yeah.
So.
Ooh, there's a misprint in the rules. There's a 1 there and there should be a 2. Fortunately, none way Steven Garrett. Take care.
Ooh,
there's a high pop fly.
There's a pop-up.
It's in the 6th zone.
Eric's
going
over to get it.
Eric missed it.
Got it.
He is safe.
Oh. Mike Finn got it, but just the hang time was just too much. It was up in the air 3 seconds, and he was halfway to the base before they could get a beat on where the ball was at. Mike Finn got it up as quick as he could, just wasn't quick enough.
Taiwan draws first blood here, 1-0. 2 outs.
Got
2 outs.
Got 2 down. Got 2 down. And
one.
And Leo has not struck anybody out yet.
52.
One of them was a deep hit. That Austin stole run from him with that out. And those are the kinds you gotta have. You gotta have those kind of hits. You gotta have those kind of hits. You gotta have those kind of plays.
It's 25.
21.
21. Okay, number 21.
He didn't want that one. It was a little bit low. All right. So, all right, he's lining back up. There comes the pitch. It's a little high on that one. He splits the difference. He'll get him right on the bat. One went under the bat and one went over the bat. U team cool. K-U-O. Cool?
I call him cool. So, especially if he makes his hit, he'd be super cool. Let's see.
There we go.
Ooh. Strike 4. 3 outs. Going to the bottom of the first. Going to switch it up here, and Austin's going to give their shot here.
All right, Blackhawks.
They got to win the inning.
Hey, Jordan. If you're going to be here, you can't root for the teams.
We're independent in here. Which runner made the, which batter made the run?
Number three, three hole. So it wasn't
35.
Yeah.
Koo made the run. Okay.
So number 21
struck out. Yep. So we'll be up to 35 or 52.
Okay.
Up to bat for the Austin Blackhawks, number two, Lupe Perez.
Uh-oh. Lupe Perez, who, you know, if I know him real well, he's going to let go of what happened in the last game and just focus on what he needs to do right now.
Looks like he's got him a new blindfold this year.
Yeah. Does it say Blackhawks on it?
It,
there's some Austin. Know.
The last one had the painting on it.
Right, right.
He dressed it up himself. I don't know if it's got anything on it or not.
There you go. Again, he was out for the last few games because of a calf strain and a little bit of some back spasms, but he's going to muscle up here.
Got to power through it. This is a game of attrition. You know, you got to know what your limit is. You got to be able to push that limit.
And that wind just starts up. It just feels good around here.
It just whips around. And I hope it's not on the microphone. We have the microphone as covered as we can, but still talking into it.
Okay. I don't know if those 30 seconds got started or not, but
he's still making
move.
A motion.
They were doing the practice pitches there.
Okay, they're in the field now. They're doing fine
gotcha.
Tuning in the field.
Gotcha. Kevin and Kenny still do the back and forth here. As
overhand throwing. Well, I tell you what, overhand throwing a beat ball is it's crazy. It's so heavy.
1 pound. 16 inches in diameter.
All right, Kevin's on the line. Nope, that's an all black mask look he's wearing.
Okay.
He's set. Here we go.
Oh, that sounded like maybe it was a grounder, though. The ball is up.
Got him.
Wow.
It's just like Taiwan started, a nice hit.
Yep.
Ground ball went through two people to the deep guy on the 3-4 side, 3-4 hole on the third base side. It was right on that line. They made a call, went over the first guy. The second guy couldn't get to it. It was just too fast.
Oh.
Third guy, deep, he got the ball.
Zachary Amulo about to give it a shot here. Getting a new ball. Yeah, we went about three innings without getting a new ball in the first game, but
Kevin's on the line. They fine-tuned the defense again. Everybody's back on their spots. All right, Kevin's at the 40-foot line. He's waiting for the umpire to say play ball. One out.
Zach, I am correct. Pretty much scored on every play except for one or two in the last time. So he's on today.
Here we go. Here comes the pitch to Zach. Cut, hit the bottom of the bat. Foul ball.
All right. Both pitchers are pretty on right now. They're getting contact.
Here we go. He's got a little too high. Pulled it up too much. You want to miss? You want to miss high, though. You don't want to catch that bottom of the bat and have a put out.
No, sir.
Ooh, oh, he clubs it.
Sounded
it's
awesome.
Six. It's deep six. That was at least 120 in the air.
Yeah. Wow.
Oh, what a play he made on it. Didn't hear the call, and he run out there and stopped the ball from rolling away from him. Oh, gosh, they want this so bad.
Yeah. Taiwan is.
He'd have missed that base. No matter how deep that was, that guy had it down right. And if he'd have missed that base, he'd have been out. I
mean, tied.
These guys are hungry.
1-1.
So hungry.
Michael Finn.
Now batting number 32, Mike Finn.
Struggled in the first game, but he got it kind of going and towards the end when it mattered.
All right, so run me back down again on this loop and that here.
Loop it and Zach. Here's Mike Finn. Now Zach just hit.
Top half of the bat. That's what I'm saying. The one that they told me isn't the one they just used.
Right, right.
So
it's a little different. Axel will probably be next.
And then Mike?
Yeah, they switched Zach and Mike.
Okay.
This is Mike Finn.
Top half of the bat. He's in there.
Oh, MF, come on, baby.
We're talking to you know.
I hear Axel over here in on deck circle, so it's definitely Axel next. Then we'll have Eric and.
All right, here we go.
Eric and Brandon. Hey.
Third pitch. Mike got a piece of it. English took it out. The spin on the ball, peeled it out to the foul. Umpire throws it back to Kevin. Kevin's looking at the spot.
I think they're, it's 0-3 count.
They're getting back in position in the field still. Evans looking at the field, looking at the field. Okay, they said they're good. Kevin's on the mark. Comes the pitch.
Wow,
oh, Mike gets a piece of it.
That sounds like a good hit.
On the.
He's there.
Oh, Mike.
He is safe.
Mike made it to the bag. It hung up there in the air, and it got him a good piece of the run to the base before they could get after the ball.
Makes it 2-1. Makes it 2-1.
It was about 120. It hit, and with the English of the spin, it just rolled away from him. You know, sometimes the ball what rolls to you, and sometimes it
rolls away.
All right, Axel Cox is up.
All right. You know, the Blackhawks are pretty blessed to have a bunch of cool heads on their starting lineup. You know? Axel's one of them. Confident. Mike Finn, Eric, Zach, Loopy. The only one that sometimes struggles is Brandon, but he's shown up today on both sides of the field, so he's got it in control. Here comes X. Like that hit.
Well, swung a little late on that one down the first base side. Right-handed big batter swinging late. Fouls one into the crowd over on the right side. I think everybody got out of the way. I don't think anybody got hit. A 2-1 score here. Austin got two. Taiwan's got one. Game set where he wants it. Another late hit, another late swing into the fouled it off from the crowd softly. Went into the crowd softly. Okay. Axel takes a good cut.
Strike four.
Strike four.
Two outs. 2-1. Here comes Brandon.
Oh, Brandon. Number 30, Brandon Cheshire.
And then Eric will be in the sixth hole. I hear John Fleming giving some words of encouragement to
Eric. Eric's on deck.
In the on deck circle.
Here we go, number 37.
Brandon. Oh, dead ball. Hit the pitcher.
Hit him right in the bread basket.
Uh-huh. I wonder. I bet you probably got more hits on you just because you've been pitching longer than Kevin, but I've seen him hit so many times.
Oh, I tell you, you know, we talked about this in the first game, you know. A scared man can't be a pitcher.
Nope.
You got to be able to take a hit.
And you gotta be a little edgy. You gotta be ready, you know. Brave.
Comes a bitch.
Nice.
Right, six, right at the six hole. Oh, past the first guy. Second guy's in front of it.
Ball's
he got
up.
He got it up. It went right over Kevin's right shoulder, right up the six hole. I thought for sure the first guy was going to get it, but it jumped over him. Second guy in the line, they lined up perfectly. Second guy in the line picks it up. So now at the bottom of the first inning, we have 2-1. Austin's got a one-run lead on Taiwan.
And if that's probably one of the other weaknesses, I think, in the lineup between the two teams is Brandon is probably the one who is probably the slowest to that base. So he's going to really have to dig deep and make sure he gets a good hit to give him that opportunity. He and Eric might be the...
Now he gets a big hit, but their deep guys are, you know, just as good as their front guys.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah.
And they're rangy. They move around good. They know where the ball's at. They get over and they cut it off too. They've learned to cut that, intersect that ball as it's rolling. And that's the thing with this game is you can't just pick up a stop ball. You can't wait for it to stop. These guys hit it too hard. You have to get out there and intersect a rolling ball or you aren't going anywhere in this game.
In number 35. If they're rolling through the same lineup as they did earlier, should be up.
So I was told that both Kevin and Wayne are Jim Quinn Award winners. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, you know, Jim Quinn founded, you know, one of the founders of Beat Baseball back in the mid-70s, played for a long time. I believe we still have some of his family still in the league, Miss Kathy Quinn, who's on the board. But we've also got a commemorative coin to recognize him now that they're going to use for every flip at every game, coin toss before every game. And that's really cool. Everybody has their founder. Every organization has their founder. And we appreciate Jim Quinn, and we recognize people who give of themselves, you know, wholeheartedly to this sport, and they get recognized at our banquet every year.
Number 52.
Austin has had a few Jim Quinn Awards. Miss Sylvia Redman and Rusty Reams have all received the Jim Quinn Award.
Oh, they all give selflessly.
Yes.
All right, we got 52 up to bat. He's the one that kind of squats a little bit. Big guy, brings the bat low. I think there was a foul tip on that one.
I did not hear it.
Bottom half of the bat. Second pitch. Got a foul on that one. They come out sideways. Of course, he's got that low swing, so it may not be early. It just may be the, you know,
right,
the inside part of the bat hits it.
Right.
All right, he's lining up again with the bat.
Yeah, those golf swings, man. You got to be right on. Both sides of the plate there.
All right, here we go.
And batter.
He's got a third baseline shot.
Sounded high.
It's going out to Lupe.
Lupe.
Lupe got in front of it and picked that ball up on the roll. Once again, we talk about intercepting the rolling ball, and that's exactly what happened. Both sides can do it. Both sides are making putouts deep. If you don't make those deep putouts, this game will get away from you.
Usually we always try to teach our defenders when they get the ball to say up or ball. Lupe always says, got it. And it's pretty cool. Shows his intensity, makes him unique.
About 90% of the teams, that would have been a run.
Yeah.
But not on this team.
No. Lupe came off the injury reserves there and made a play.
It was a good play, I must say. I didn't think he was going to make it. I think that crown roll speeded that ball up. If it had slowed down at all, he would have been there. Number 25, the bottom of their order, Shao Hu Hung. He got a piece of one in the first game, but he needs to get a piece of every one, you know.
Yeah.
He needs to put the pressure on, make them make a play.
Oop.
We got the bottom half of the bat. Leo's tapping his chest like it's me, it's me.
Top of two, 2-1, one out. Second game.
Here comes Leo's pitch. Oh no, no, he was behind that one. He didn't get the bat around in time for that.
This is the final and determining game of the Beat Baseball World Series in 2015. And
okay. All right, Leo's talking. Here we go. Oh, we got all of it. Ooh. It's up in the air. It's over Eric. It's bouncing. Mike's in front of it.
Ball is up.
Mike got it.
Austin is on fire here with the placement.
They're not going to give an inch if they can help it. Yeah, Mike Finn got in front of it.
Two outs.
We're back to the top of the order, number 55.
Now batting number 55.
Wen Chin Chu is now at the bat. And I mean, he tied into that one, but it just kind of stopped there in front of Mike Finn. It was hopping, and I thought it was going to go over Mike, but he got in front of it and got it stopped.
Last time Zach Arambula put this guy out, let's see if he goes the same direction, which is, you know, kind of the right field.
I think Leo's testing different parts of the field to see where he needs to start working.
Oof.
Foul ball on the first base side. It's going into the crowd. Nope, going into our cameraman.
Both of these teams have full power.
Again, got to give mad props to Graham Mathena, who brought all his equipment from Arlington, Texas, to make sure we're streaming and get good video and snag some good audio so that...
Well, if you didn't see the first game, you need to go back and watch it when it gets put up, because that was one heck of a game. You know? All right, here he comes. Got a foul ball. He got a little under that one. If he'd have got all of it, that would have been a fair ball. His timing's cleared up. He's right on it. He'd been down first baseline. Pretty good hit. Top of the bat. Kind of got some English and jumped off the side. Still, he's dropping the tip of that bat. I'm thinking he's a little tired.
Oh, yeah. I wouldn't blame him.
The tip of the bat's falling just a little bit. Bench is coaching the field if they can.
He's going to strike him out.
He got him. Sometimes it makes you wonder, you know, three strikes and they start.
That's middle of the second, man. Yeah.
Top of second.
Yeah, we just got
bottom second.
Middle of the second inning. Austin coming up. Austin with a 2-1 lead.
Sure.
Attention, everyone. If you'd like to purchase anything, the concession stand will only remain open till 6 o'clock.
15 after. 5.
Another 45 minutes.
Frank's not here.
All right, looks like we're starting off with Eric Mazariegos, number 10.
Now at the bat, number 10, Eric Mazariegos, number 10.
They went 3-up, 3-down. That doesn't happen much, but that feels good for Austin, so they can use this to take advantage and go up by some insurance runs here, spread this lead up. Eric Mazariegos.
They just said that he was taped.
Oh, he's patched up.
That's what they said.
Okay.
Tell them about what that means.
Well, you know, there's a special stipulation now that if a team requests for another player to be patched, they put two Pirates patches on each eye, and they tape it pretty much all around, including your nose and the side of, you know, your temples, and and then they put a blindfold on top of that. It's mainly just to make sure.
Funny as it may seem, the procedure of taping was corrected entirely by Eric and approved by the Empires.
Yep. Eric Mazaregos came up with the rules, so he...
Not necessarily just the whole process.
Oh, the process. Gotcha.
It was patterned. It was patterned after a process used in another another sport, the go ball sport.
Ooh.
All right, Eric gets a hit. It's high pop fly. It's foul. He's out in front of it. Third base side. He got in front of the pitch a little bit. But it was patterned after a go ball rule. The taping
right
was.
In the Paralympics, right?
So.
Ooh, that sounded like a great hit.
Third baseline, it got by number 25.
He's safe.
It was a line shot, literally within 3 foot of the first base line.
Yeah, man.
And
that sounded like a shotgun, man. Shotgun blast. Wow.
So.
Yeah, he changed his pitch of that ball for sure.
Number 25 went after it, just couldn't quite make it over there.
What's consistent about Eric and why he has been on 21 all tournaments is, as I'm sure he's going to be on there today, without any doubt, is that he's consistent all the way through and on both sides of the ball. He's just a phenomenal player and just puts his heart and soul to everything he does.
He is an excellent player. He's an all-round player.
And here we're back up to Luby Perez, the infamous power hitter of beat baseball.
Oh, he got the top of the grounder. Ball. And
the ball's up. He's out.
And he missed the base.
Oh. And he had a little issue with the base. Just probably a little too amped.
Well, and
coming up the bat, number 2, Luby Perez.
He probably believes that he got pitched low on that.
Zach.
I'm sorry, Zach now?
Yeah, Luby just got out.
My apologies, now batting number 24, Zach Arambula.
So anyway, Luby was just a little bit early, and his bat had already cleared the strike zone.
Right.
And so it caught the bottom of the bat out in front of him, causing the ball to go into the ground.
Strike one. Zach's been pretty much on fire all day, offensively and defensively. He's made a couple of really good putouts, so he trains all year for this.
All right, got the bottom of the bat. It's foul ball.
Foul ball!
Certified in CrossFit. Talks to me a lot about, you know, he climbs all these walls and does all these chin-ups and throws tires around. But, definitely a great physical shape.
Everybody's kind of out in front of Kevin. I think they're amped up. That was another early swing, see? I think they said something to Eric about waiting, and that's when he got that hit down first baseline. But Luby's been out in front of him. Zach's out in front of him. You know, and that's causing those grounders. Got to wait till that ball gets into the pocket.
3-1. One out. Again, Zach won an MVP his rookie season at 16 years old.
Okay, here comes. Pitch. Over the top.
Struck out. That's hard. Two outs.
Who's that?
It's Mike Finn's up.
Mike Finn.
Now batting number 32, Mike Finn.
You're right. The taping process is, it looks pretty arduous. Mike Finn's been taped also.
Oh, wow.
I can see it coming out from underneath his blindfold.
And I do know Eric and Mike do have some usable vision, so Taiwan probably did their homework there and decided to tape them. Ooh.
Oh, he hit it down first base. Oh, it's
my
a foul
gosh.
Ball.
That sounded cool too, though. But
yeah, he got a. It went to the soccer goal. Wow. It was a hard hit ball down the first base line.
They're going to want a new ball if I were them.
Kevin checking with him.
No.
Nope. He tossed it in. Kevin checked with him, make sure.
Yeah.
Kevin, as soon as the ball's hit two or three times, I don't think he minds having it changed out.
Yeah.
You know, it gives the defense a better chance, but also gives him a hard ball to hit.
Right.
You know, the harder the ball, the better the spring off the bat. So, you know, I mean.
Yep, they got a new one.
Yep, and it sounds good, too. That's a good sounding ball right there.
Who's where are all the balls being mass produced now, Steve?
They still doing it in Colorado, right?
The Denver Beatball Group?
Making the balls in the bases, yes.
Yeah, okay.
All right, here we go. Mike's up. We got a first base side hit. It's about the two zone. It's bouncing in front of number 25.
He's safe.
Just over his hand. Once again, it goes back to that high pop fly. With the ball in the air, you're halfway to the base before it comes down. Mike's long legs just carry him down there. He just glides down there to the base.
Blackhawks trying to roll on two.
So that makes the score
4-1
at the
bottom of second.
Bottom of second.
You know, again, the beat baseballs cost about $35 a piece. And you can find all that information on mbba.org. Bases are about 500.
Axel's up now.
A pair of bases and the control box, the switch. You know, there's a lot of electronics that goes involved in this, and that's why the expense is a little high, and that's why we appreciate any donations to mbba.org. Tax write-offs. You can donate a car.
Boat. You can donate about anything, I think.
Yeah.
Cash is appreciated.
Okay. Axel Cox back up to bat.
Got a little cloud cover now. Foul tip, top half of the bat. Kevin flicking right down the pipe. Oh, got the top half of the bat, foul ball.
Coming right over here to us.
Yep.
Right at my feet.
Get in.
Can I get the foot out? Yeah. Okay, so Axel's, I think, at three strikes here. Oh, he's hanging in there, man. They've connected every single time, so. Here we go. Kevin's telling him to wait for it.
He must see the same thing we're seeing there, Richie.
Yeah.
He says it's a little early.
Oh,
yeah, fell right in the
grounder.
Pocket.
Ooh, went under the first guy.
Deep guy. Oh, it hit his glove, bounced out. He got the base.
He's safe.
Five to one.
Two outs. Bottom of second. Austin is starting to pull away here. The base is still on.
Number 30.
It'll be Brandon Chesser. Again.
Number 30, Brandon Chesser.
Brandon Chesser's jersey from last year has been put up in a display for Beat Baseball in the Baseball Hall of Fame.
Yeah, I think that game and him was featured on a Sunday morning.
Yeah, that's right. You guys can look up CBS News Monday morning or Sunday morning news. Excellent, excellent documentary on the life of family life and the beat baseball life of Brandon, and great illustration of what this sport's all about.
Oh, ooh. Brandon got all of that one. It hit him in the arm.
Oh,
it went over his arm too.
He is safe.
Oh,
wow.
Oh,
man.
That's heartbreaking right there. Heartbreaking.
Hit two people.
It hit two people, and nobody could make a stop on it.
Yep. Well, it was crushed, so I can imagine, you know, having to try to stop that one when it's coming so fast. You know, you do your best. Say off of me. That's another cue that we like to give our
Austin's called
defenders.
A timeout. They
they're calling timeout in there.
Austin?
Yeah, offensive timeout. Did a little huddle up over there at the Austin bench. Left Eric standing at the play.
Well, they. I'm sure
okay,
they.
Okay, Loop has a number 2 on his new blindfold. That's all he's got.
That's what it is.
Eric Mazariegos.
Eric Mazariegos.
Eric hit another one straight up the middle. Nobody's out there.
He's safe. They're pulling away. They're making a run, kind of like they did early in the game last.
I don't know what happened. The two guys were kind of on top of each other out there, the two Taiwan defenders. They're supposed to be separated by more than that, and both of them was. Almost stepped on one another, but the ball went through. And so Lupe, we're at the top of the order with Lupe Perez.
Who has not scored yet.
Number 2, so Lupe Perez.
He's due, man. He's due for a big hit here. He's gotten his cuts.
They've asked for another new ball. Of course, Kevin loves a good hard ball, so he'll let him have any as many. He won't say nothing about it. It's a World Series game. You might as well have the best of the equipment. Okay. All right, Kevin's going to get a couple of pitches with the new ball. He's having to work for this one, I'll tell you that right now.
And you got to just, believe that his injury is so legit, and he's just powering through this.
Okay, well, Lupe, he's got the timing down now. He just barely missed the bat. Here comes another swing by Lupe Perez. Little high.
You can hear that whish of that bat, man.
Yeah, when he gets a hold of it, they'll know about it.
With velocity.
Foul tip.
All right. Wow.
Oh, there it went. Six
There's
hole.
Lupe
it is
Perez
deep.
Hit.
Oh, he's trying to chase it down. It's.
He's safe.
I think that went all the way to the street. There's people sitting out there in the carts, golf carts out there, and one of them had to go pick up the ball and toss it back in.
7-1.
8-1.
And I tell you, after I saw how far the ball went, I was watching Lupe, and he was adjusting all the way to the base. He did not, after that missed base, he was pulling to the right, and then he pulled back to the left. He went right straight into the base. He wasn't going to miss another base. 24?
Yep. Back to
now
Zach.
Batting, Zach Aranula, number 24.
Put up 6 runs.
There's a defensive timeout on the field.
So Taiwan's got a powwow going out there. They're talking it over. They're getting thumped pretty good with these power hits that Austin's been hitting into Taiwan's defense.
Yep, Kevin's getting on fire.
When you get a string of them together like that, you don't want to sit down. You want to keep going and going and going.
They get 6 more and it'll be in the 12 run. Getting another ball.
Of course, isn't that what happened the other day it was a 12-run rule, and then somebody 12-run the other team back when they come back to the field. So, the score at this point don't mean nothing until the sixth inning closed out.
Again, we got 6 innings. We get 18 outs, 4 strikes, 1 pass ball. You run either first or third base. And beat baseball.
All right, he's got the bat up. Kevin's ready.
Oof.
had a good swing. I think Kevin, once again, he's making sure he don't hit the bottom of the bat.
He struck him out last time.
Oh, got the bottom of the bat. It's on the ground. It's going up the four hole. Deep guy's got it.
Batter's out. Three outs.
I guess that little powwow must have helped a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, just even to break the rhythm a little bit.
8-1.
8-1.
Top of the third.
Top of three.
Going into the top of the third, Austin with an 8-1 advantage.
He hit it hard right up the middle of the field in the four hole on the third base side. And once again, we talked so much about intersecting with the ball. You have to get over there, you have to get in front of the ball, know where it's going to be so that you can get the ball. And that's exactly what happened that time. The ball got out there faster than the base runner could run. The deep guy got it. Those pop flies where you get it four or five steps out of the box before it touches the ground, those are the ones you're looking for. You got to have those kind of flies to give the batters a chance. Those hard hit line shots that go straight out to the outfield. These outfielders today, they're just too good for that. All right, we got the DH number 9.
I was talking to a guy last night.
Ching. Now batting number 9 from Taiwan home run.
About
Ching Kei Chin.
About the pitcher's guide to beat baseball, written by Frank Mathena. I think you could still find it out there on the web.
It's on YouTube.
Pitcher's guide. So if there's any aspiring pitchers, or pitchers who are willing to develop, go on YouTube and look for Pitcher's Guide to Beat Baseball by Frank Mathena. And you'll learn a thing or two. I talked to somebody about it last night. Who's actually just a player. He's trying to get more information for his, you know, developing pitcher and developing team, and said it was very beneficial. Both Kevin and Leo have both studied that, I'm sure, and perfected their own techniques.
Together a couple of training videos on the different aspects of the game, getting the ball, playing the ball, playing the intersection of the line drives, things like that. We want to raise the whole level of everybody in the game.
Number 9.
That was a hit up 6. I can't see because the umpire, he just turned around and did exactly to them what was done by them to Taiwan. He turned around and did the exact same thing. Their DH just ripped one right up the 6 hole and went right over or right by Mike. I couldn't see because of the umpire, but it was a heck of a hit and it went deep.
8-2. Taiwan's responding back. Man.
Yeah, when the game pushes, you got to push back, and Taiwan does the best at pushing back. Okay, we got number 35 up to bat. Kun Tai Koo. All right, so number 35. Once again, he's hit the home run this year.
He also made the go-ahead one or tying run.
In the last game.
Yeah.
Here we go. Leo's on the spine. Oh, wow. What a hit. Loopy's over. Oh, he run past it. He turned his head sideways when he was running. He didn't keep his face towards the ball, overrun the ball. Now, he may not have been able to get it, but he overrun the line of the ball and turned and tried to come back, and it was already past him. But the ball was so fast.
He murdered that ball. It's a different pitch. Oh, it just changed again.
All right, number 52, I think. It's
22.
21.
Now batting number 21.
8-3, no outs yet.
I can't stress enough how keeping your face towards the ball. I don't think Luby had much of a chance at that one, but he turned his head and run sideways versus trying to stay in line with his face towards the ball.
Now the wind did pick up. The pitch did change after he hit it, so could be a mixture of all those things just throwing Luby off.
Oh, you can't blame him for that.
No.
That was a well-hit ball, the wind, everything. He almost got. He got over there, but he just wasn't able to get down. Yeah, he did everything he could do with that one. Here comes Leo with another pitch. Oh, there's a hop fly. It's in the middle of the field.
Eric.
No, Axel got it.
Axel, who's now playing the short
front
right field.
Yes, yep. He got it. It was on the 5-6 line on the first base side. Kind of a pop fly. It just died once it hit the ground. So there was nowhere for it to go, and Axel just went over and got it.
I don't think Axel's ever played anything other than short. He's now moved back to the mid level, but he is a specialist up front. And he would be the four in a shortstop if Eric Mazarigos wasn't on this team. But him being up front is legit, and they're gonna nothing's gonna get by.
You know, being comfortable in a position means a lot. All right, here comes the pitch. Oh, he's got a good hit down the third baseline.
And they're on
Loopy's
fire
in
here.
Front of it this time. Hit him in the hand and moved away, and he's there.
He's safe.
Now, Loopy intersected that ball, and it hit him and bounced away. I mean, these are hard hits. That was all a good play by Loopy. He was right in front of it, but the ball just ricocheted off his hand and got far enough away he couldn't do it.
We're at 8-4 now. Right.
It's 8-4 now, and
one out.
And Lupe has done about everything he could do over there for that ball, that last one. It's no fault of his. He was in front of it, and it was a hard hit ball. And once again, he did not turn his head away from the ball. Got perfectly lined up in front of it.
Here's number 35.
25. 25's had a couple of good hits, but he's. His base running is just a little bit slow. He's a hard swinger, I'll tell you that right now. He pulls that bat through with authority. All right, Leo's on the rubber. Here we go. Oh, he went under him again. He's had two pitches underneath of him.
What is this?
25. Shoo-hoo-hung. Goes. Leo threw under him three times. I don't know what's on. I don't know what's going on here. I don't know if he's changed his swing or if Leo just missing the spot. There he got him.
Found it.
It's a ground ball. It's fast. It got by Eric.
Ooh.
It's still rolling. Got by Mike.
Oh, no.
Oh, and Lupe was. Oh, my God.
Just a beat off it.
It was just like the ball knew where to go.
Mm-hmm.
It had a 6-inch hole that it could make it through the defense, and it found that 6-inch hole.
Little angels in the outfield there for Taiwan.
Golly.
It's getting under everybody.
You have to wonder if that crown didn't cause a little bit of movement on that. From our angle, I can't see if they were perfectly lined up in a line. But it was on Mike's right side, Lupe's left side. Makes you wonder if there was not just a little bit of roll on that crown.
Yep.
Number 55, top of the order.
Not batting, number 55.
Top of the order here. Leo is bringing them back. He's,
mm-hmm. We're
he's,
at 8-5.
He's taking,
one out.
He's taking
four
his
runs.
Willpower, and he's pushing back. He's got his shoulder in the load.
Yes, sir. Got to give it to these Taiwanese. Such a great physical fitness to play these many games in one day, 11 in 1 week.
Okay, here he comes. Oh, Oh, it's a ground ball up 6-hole. It's heading right toward Mike. Mike Finn got his hands out. It went over Mike's hands.
Oh, no.
He made it to the bag.
He's safe. They're having some issues out there. Maybe the defense is getting a little tired or, you know, not hitting the ball right.
Felt comfortable with that lead.
Yep.
And wasn't expecting the hit. Wasn't that the first pitch?
Yep.
You know, you catch them off guard with that first pitch.
Here's number 9.
There is nothing better for me than to hit that bat on the first pitch. The defense is standing there, and all of a sudden the ball's on them. Just boom, just there, you know. I love it.
All right, here's number 9.
Comes number 9, their DH, Ching Ken Chen.
Now batting number 9.
Still getting used to these bifocals.
Yes, sir. Number 9 has been doing everything he needed to do all day.
Probably he's wanting to make sure he's got it. He's got it locked in now. It was a little bit off, he says. He didn't want to run into the crowd, so they turned the speaker, the bass to him. All right, here we go.
You remember, too, this is on the first play of the game. He also ran into Leo earlier this
season. Right. Doesn't seem to have bothered Leo.
Or him. Wow.
He ripped one. They're picking on Lupe.
Dang.
They are picking on Lupe Perez. I'm telling you what, every hit has been to Lupe. I think they've decided he's the weak link, and they're gonna knock it to him every time. That went over the crown of the hill and fell in like a mortar shell back here on Lupe Perez.
Man, they mean business, man.
Now it's 7-8.
Wow, one out still.
Uh-oh, they called a defensive timeout.
Yep.
Still sitting on one out. Coming up, number 35. Number 35 is the home run hitter this year. And Kung Tai Ku. Number 35.
Number 35 for Taiwan home run is up to bat.
All right, they broke the huddle out in the outfield there. They're putting them in place. Catcher's coming back.
Still only one out in this inning, so they can tie it up here.
And they can put, like I said, once the game pushes you, you have to learn to push back. Leo ain't taking it. He's not letting the game push him. He's pushing back. One down, the umpire's reminded everybody it's one down. Pins pulled from the ball. Yeah, they are. They're working Lupe over.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're doing it on purpose or if it's just accidental, but almost every one of them can hit right to him.
I haven't heard anything go to Zach.
You know, middle of the field to the left side of the field. That's where they've been hitting it.
Eric has not made a put out yet in this game.
And that swing right there, if it had been on the bat, it would have been down Lupe's side of the field again.
Yep.
I think it's purposeful. I think they're doing it on purpose.
Yep. Good pitchers can do that, man. Leo and Kevin are both those that way. And let's see if they do it again.
We go. Oh, he kind of looped that ball up in the air. Yeah, he's hitting himself in the chest. He pointed to the highness of the ball, and it was the arc was too high. It couldn't match the bat swing that time. It fell through the strike zone instead of floating through the strike zone at the same parallel of the bat. So Leo takes credit for the miss on that one. All right, here we go. Leo's. A foul ball. He got the top off the bat. That was a good pitch right there. Yeah, they're calling Axel, but I'm telling you, if he gets contact, it's going to be on the right side or left side of the field. It'll be Leo's right side, but left side of the field to us.
Wow.
It's in the middle. It's up in the air.
Mike.
Mike Finn's got it.
Mike got it, yep. two outs.
He called a late base. He called a late base. The umpire says no late base. That the base changed the pitch. It starts off, goes and makes two different noises. And when it made the second noise, he thought it was late.
Yeah, it does it every time now.
Almost every time.
Third base, that is. So we're at 7-8 or? Or is it 8-8?
It is 7-8 still.
7-8, all right.
One out left in this inning.
Number 21.
You know, it's kind of odd. We're sitting right here. They could walk right in that room back there and get a base that doesn't do that.
Right.
You know, they got this.
Dan Green, our president, is running the bases, and he's usually pretty on top of it.
They got a whole room full of bases in there. They could go pull another base.
21.
Well, no, batting number 21.
Let's see if we can tie it up here. Make this a new game for Taiwan and Austin in the second game of the double elimination round between Blackhawks and Taiwan. Home run.
That time it didn't do it. I don't know. It must be intermittent. It didn't make any noise at all. It didn't change tone at all is what I'm trying to say.
And some of the technology is a little primitive, but it works, you know.
You have to use something that can last. Yeah. You can't. Some of the new.
Now first base is doing it, so it might be a controller thing. I don't know. It's interesting.
The technology might be nice sometimes, but sometimes it's not rugged enough.
Oh,
Leo was just under him. Timing looked good that time.
They are working on developing some wireless bases, which would be kind of cool to see.
Yeah, I've seen those. All right, he's talking to him. Okay. Oh, he's got a ground ball up the six hole. It's Eric's special.
Or Axe. Eric, yeah. Oh, Mazarego retires the side there.
He hit the ball in the bag.
8-7.
Austin 8, Taiwan 7.
All right, I got to get something to drink. I'm about to.
No problem. Just recall that we are in Rochester, New York at the 2015 World Series. Thank you to all the tournament committee members, all the MBBA board members, all the volunteers. Putting on a great tournament that's not over yet. At about 5:40 p.m. because Taiwan had to play a game this morning against the RHI Extreme to be in the championship game.
The banquet will start tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern time.
They then won the first game against Austin after a controversial, very
one hour prior, the a cash
interference call
for a lounge for you.
That
but
was
the doors will be open for the teams to proceed.
Overturned
in
about three or four times.
15 minutes prior to 9 o'clock. So you can find your table.
And here we
remember,
are.
Your tables will have placards on them.
They're still neck and neck.
Where you're sitting.
8-7. Austin's going to come up to bat, and let's see how they react to what just happened. They put up a bunch of runs. Taiwan
not
met
batting.
Them.
Number 32, Mike Finn.
Met them at six. I think both of them put six runs up in the last two innings. Last two half innings. Tim, our play-by-play guy, just needed to get a drink of water. He's coming back soon. I'll do my best to hear what's happening. Sounds like he's coming back, so. Zach Aravula. Up to bat. Oh, Michael Finn up to bat. First pitch strike. Michael Finn, number 32. He's been playing with Austin Blackhawks since the West Coast Dogs folded back in 2011. So he's been with us since 2012 with Austin. Again, I apologize for saying us sometimes, because I, up till probably about 4 months ago, I was part of the team, so. Sounded like a good hit, but up front, he's safe. He's good enough to make a run. I heard Taiwan out there talking to each other. Somebody must have missed it.
A good hit by Mike. It was, I could see the pop fly over my shoulder.
Axel 22. Cox. Yep.
Now batting number 22, Axel Cox.
Axel Cox, aka my roommate for the week.
Alright, Axel's up.
We're looking forward to going back to New York City tomorrow and celebrating a win, but we'll see what happens.
So where are we at? Fourth inning?
This is the top of four.
Top of four.
Actually, sorry, bottom of third.
Oh, that's right. Their home team.
Austin's home this time, so bottom of third.
All right, here we go. Here comes the pitch.
9-7.
Swing and a hit. Mm. It's going to be foul.
Okay.
The timing would have pushed
the way
it.
That sounded.
Timing would have pushed it straight down the first base line, but with the spin on the ball, it pulled it out foul pretty quick once it touched the ground.
Right, Axel Cox has been playing since 2008.
They're still talking. They're still talking in the field.
He's been instrumental in the rebuilding of the Austin Blackhawks in the last 10 years. And I think.
All right, here they go. He's got the bat up.
Definitely Kevin one of the Smith. Franchise players locally. Strike two.
The timing was better on that one. And he was just a little under the bat. So, all right, Kevin's getting ready to throw another one. Got the bat out. Comes the pitch. Over the top this time.
Strike three. Based out of San Antonio, Texas, Axel Cox is right here at three strikes.
No balls.
No balls.
He got a hold of that one. It's the three hole and the first base side over the first guy. All right, he's going to have to talk to the umpire, Kemp. Kemp's the only one that can see the ball and the base at the same time.
He's safe.
He called it from the field. He could see the ball. We couldn't see it from here. The ball was covered by the player's body in the field, the Taiwanese player's body. Blocked the view from us and the umpire at home plate. So he checked with the umpire on the first base side, had a view all the way to the third base across the player, and he says he was safe.
Up to 10-7, no outs.
He had a good view of it.
And here comes Brandon.
Now batting, number 30, Brandon Chesser.
Uncle Mike out there who's...
Looks like there's one cloud heading our way.
Actually, officially Eric Mazarego's uncle, but everybody refers to him as Uncle Mike. You hear him giving some encouragement.
He's my Uncle Mike, too.
Yeah, he's everybody. He's the NBBA Uncle Mike.
He's NBBA Uncle Mike. We have an uncle in the NBBA. We have a cousin in the NBBA.
That's right.
We're all just one big happy family.
That is true.
Number 30.
It's, we talked about the Simpsons, your daughter was been coming with you, Tim, since she was a kid.
Oh yeah.
She does a lot of volunteering, scorekeeping now.
She spotted, she caught.
You know, Mike Woodard's out there, and there's a whole mess of Woodards.
Oh, he got all of that one. It's up in the air a long ways.
Wow.
It's deep. It's past the second guy. Third guy's trying to flag it down. He can't get it to stop bouncing. He was there flailing in the air as it was bouncing around him. It was so high and just kept bouncing. There was no chance at stopping the ball. There was no rolling on that ball at all.
They are on a roll again here. No outs. Is it 11?
11-7.
11-7.
No outs.
Yeah, the Woodards are another kind of beat ball family that, you know, Jared Woodard's a pitcher, and Clint Woodard's a player, and Mike Woodard's our umpire. Now they even have one of the first female pitchers, Lindsay Woodard, who's pitching for the Indianapolis Knights.
Oh, Eric gets all of it first pitch.
Eric
right down
Mazarigos.
5-6 line, middle of the field.
What a
it's
solid
over
hit.
The bot. He missed the
he
base.
Missed the base. You never, I have never witnessed Eric Mazarigo miss a base in my life.
I've never seen that myself. I've never seen a base missed by Eric.
Oh.
It went to the third guy in the 5-6 line. He's double checking down there with the umpire, but he called him out from the home plate. It's got to be pretty significant for him to be overruled. But the line shot was off of the 5-6 line on the first base side. Got all the way to the third depth, and he's not changing his call.
He's going to be out, first out of the inning here at 11-7. And it brings us back up to the top at Loopy, who has yet to score since being brought back in at the end of the first game.
They shut him down, haven't they?
Yeah, and they picked on him all day on defense, too.
Let me double check. Yep, they pretty well shut him down. He's been swinging a touch early. Yeah, I think he's early there, too. It was level enough that he could have hit it, but he was swinging earlier. Earlier, he was swinging early enough to hit the bottom of the bat. He's timed up good now. He's got the time now. He may have stood over here in the batting circle and listened to those cadences and times and got them squared up. It's on the ground.
On the ground again.
Yeah.
Let's see if they get him. Ball is up.
He got him. That's it.
Loopy is about 0 for 4 for the day. Very, very just not typical.
No, I think he did get one earlier. He got one earlier because it was hit so far, and he did.
That's true.
I was talking about how he zigzagged back and forth to make sure he
that's
got
true.
That third
he did
base.
Make one.
Everybody's
okay.
Having a little bit of trouble. Number 24.
Zach Arambula.
Arambula.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
There's one cloud heading this way, and it does not look pretty.
Oh no.
I can see both sides. Sun's coming in on one side. And there's just a few light clouds on the other side. But there's a big
I'll tell you, the last time we had to play Taiwan, Austin had to play Taiwan in 2012, it was raining.
Oh, he got all of it right at the six hole. It hits him in the arm. He was standing up when it hit him in the arm. He tried to knock it down.
Zach Arambula scores again.
And if that ball would have had the full beep on it, he would have found it. He throwed his hands up in the air. It hit him in the armpit. Come down. He was looking for the ball. He could not find it.
I wonder if it's dead. Nope, I hear it.
It's squeaking.
Mm-hmm.
Now batting number 32, Mike Finn.
We at 12.
They better give him a new ball, yes.
12-7 then.
Yeah, he would have found that ball had it not changed pitch and got weaker like that.
Blackhawks have responded and put up four, so they're...
It's 12-7, that's correct. But, yeah, he did everything he can. They want this game. He could hear the ball coming, and he knew it was hopping, and rather than get down on the ground, he threw his hands up and hit him in the elbow or under his armpit. It was hard to see, but it was a hard hit ball.
So up to bat now will be Michael Finn.
32, Michael Finn. Now Mike owns a fitness center out in California. Do you know the name of that?
I do not. I did benefit a couple years ago though by getting a few workouts emailed to me by him. That
I try to use the ground ball. The 5-6 line, the player is in front of it.
He's up.
Oh my gosh, what a play. He intercepted that ball on the slide right into his leg and pulled that ball up.
Wow.
I'm telling you, that is, you know, if I didn't know better, I'd think that was Mike Finn playing Mike Finn. That's exactly what I'd say. That's the kind of...
That's how even these guys are matched up, man. I mean, you've got six solid players on both sides of the field.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And that's why I say, you know, if they find out somebody's maybe having an off day, they will pick on that one person. You know, they may have patched him because when he gets done running the base, he throws his mask up and he just kind of prances back.
Right.
Who's coming up here?
Axel.
Let's see.
Was that three outs?
It was. It's
okay.
Three outs.
So we're moving. Top of four.
Get a hold of the microphone, I'll tell you. It looks like it's the top of the order, number 55, but I can't see his number yet. Just a second. Yes. Oh, 52. It's 52.
52. 6 hole.
It's Jin Chung Chang. Yeah, he's the fifth one.
Oh, fifth.
Yeah, it's Jin Chung Chang.
Looks like they had a little bit of a wiring issue.
I have trouble with it, trying to say English words, so.
Nah, we joked a little bit about it, but we definitely apologize, you know, if we're butchering any of these names, but again, we're from the South. Southern United States. I'm from Texas and Tim's from Oklahoma, and Taiwanese is the only time we really ever meet and talk with these guys. Right. Is a deep ball.
You just gotta stick with us, you know. When you're talking to a couple of people, it's y'all, and there's a bunch of people, it's all y'all.
Yeah.
What's the score?
It's 12-7.
12-7 is the score. That's what's on the scoreboard. Yeah. Now that I've seen it was out there.
Yeah.
12-7. Let's see what Leo can come up with. He made a good run the last inning, put up 6 runs. If they do that here, they'll go up 13-12.
All right, Leo's looking down the pipe. This is the one that kind of squats a little bit. His first swing sometimes seems to be a bit stiff. Doesn't seem to be as smooth. That one was. That was very smooth. He got a piece of that one. Bottom of the bat. They got a piece of it.
Nice and loose now.
I think so. I think he was just stiff earlier in the game. Catcher's down set. He's got that golf swing. Leo don't mind pitching to it, I don't care. Uh-oh. 41, 40, 50, 50 feet. Eric's coming up on it.
One. He got it.
Cut it up.
Yep.
It was a slow roller down third baseline. And that's the thing about Eric. He knows that once he gets there, he can get that ball up in a split second. So he's not rushing. He's making sure his hands go straight to the ball, making sure that he's in front of the ball, things of that nature.
Yeah.
Those hard hit shots that go by him. You know, some people say you ought to try for him, but if he deflects the ball.
What number's up now?
At number 25.
Number 25,
yeah. Yeah, that's the one thing I learned from Eric is you don't need to rush on the defense. You need to be sure.
Exactly. And everybody needs to be sure. If you got somebody you can depend on. So you don't want to deflect the ball because they're lining up on the direction.
Man, I tell you, Molly Fleming definitely gives him some comfort up there by giving a good spot.
Okay.
I've rarely heard her make a bad call.
Mm-hmm. Got a pop fly on the first base side. Oops, foul.
For Axel.
Foul.
Okay. Oh, a couple of people yelling stop there.
Yeah, Axel was coming up, and he was at the time when his player was making a move towards the field. He had taken a step towards third base, and he was cutting back across the field. But if you know that it's a hard enough hit that it's going to get to the next guy, and you have faith in his abilities, you got to let him know and let him know it's coming. All right, there's a low.
Right down to Eric again.
Line.
He got it.
Straight
in his bread basket. That's practice.
Yeah, that's Eric's bread and butter right there. You had said earlier he didn't have very many, but
no, he's getting them now.
He is.
He's getting them when it counts. That's right now. Two outs.
No runs. It's still 7-12. They don't want to let this game get away. He better start racking up. So. All right, now we're at the top of the order, 55. Wen Shin Chu.
Now batting number 55.
Wen Shin Chu. Wow. Oh, he hit it hard, right up the middle of the field, on the six. It got by him. Oh, my gosh.
He's safe.
It was number 24. Oh, he just about made a hit.
Zach gave it a good try.
Oh, Zach made a slide right over there, and he just got by him. It was by Mike before he could even get his cleats planted to move. All right, so they got one now. They're starting to roll. This is the top of their order. These are the best batters. Number nine,
spectators are getting excited.
So here we are with the DH, the designated hitter. We do have a designated fielder, designated hitter rule. Not mentioned much about the fielder.
Not too sure who it is out there.
It's number 26.
Oh, 26, okay.
Okay, so he's set up.
We're at 14-8, or 12-8, I'm sorry.
Okay, they're setting up the field, and now they say it's okay.
First base, please. Third.
Okay.
Number nine has shown up pretty much every time. They'll take this pass. There it is.
That's pretty good timing.
I think with Dave Wanchek, who's writing the book about beat ball, guy is known as Mr. Foot.
Into the crowd on the third base side.
Because he is a licensed massage therapist out in Taiwan. He's one of the newest, youngest members.
All right, here he goes. He's got the bat up. Leo's looking down the pipe. Oh, he hits a hard... Bounces over Eric, I think. I can't see the umpires in the way. Oh, it hits Loopy and rolls away. He's there.
He's safe. Loopy again. 12-9.
It was a line shot. It was over Eric. I couldn't see if it went over or past Mike before he got there, but it was out in Loopy's territory, and it hit Loopy and ricocheted off. Those balls are just bombing out there. When he does hit the bat, they are bombing. But if he misses, it's pickups by Eric. You know, he's just got to hit the bat, and I think he's doing it on purpose. I think he's hitting them to loop on purpose.
Yeah, I mean, the closest one that's was to Zach was definitely
six.
Center.
Center of six, that's right. He hasn't hit anything on that right side on purpose for a while.
And it's interesting, you know, they know Loopy, you know. They know him. They've played him so many times.
Well, with two different teams.
Yep. And they definitely give him respect, but they also kind of know he was out for a while. So they might be testing that injury.
Top half of the bat. The timing looked good. I think he would have hit it up the center of the field. He got the bat up. Leo's looking down the pipe. Oh, he went under. He had one over and one under.
See, he splits a difference here.
Yeah, uh-huh. He's tapping his chest. He's telling the catcher, that was me. Don't change anything. The batter saying something to him. Check swing. Loosening up. Oh, Leo's looking. Here it comes. Oh, I thought that was a good. I thought that was a good pitch. Just didn't quite make it there before it dropped. He just needed to float it just a little bit farther. He has kind of an upper swing, so Leo's trying to catch that upper swing just as it starts rounding up. His practice swings aren't anything like his real swing.
Yeah, sounds familiar to me.
I went over the top.
Strike four, struck him out.
Struck him out. Now it's 9-12. Three outs, changing sides.
Going to bottom of four, 12-9.
Well done.
Austin Blackhawks. You know, one really cool thing
that
Taiwan has agreed to do, since they do speak a different language, is use our numbering system, 1-6, when they're out there on the field is spotting, and also the pitcher says set, ready, ball, which we're allowed to say, or some of us say ready, pitch, but it's kind of cool that they do respect that rule.
They are. They're taking 22 up.
Now batting number 22, Axel Cox.
Okay. Axel's done what he needs to do pretty much all day, so if he just remains calm and cool, consistent.
Start that big rally, Ax. Like you can.
It should work.
Have some fun.
Looks like rain falling over there.
Okay. Might be a little bit of water coming our way. As long as there's no lightning, we're gonna keep it going.
It's just that one cloud, though. That's the weird thing. It's just other little clouds around, and then that one big cloud's heading this way. In Oklahoma, we call those pop-up showers.
Mm-hmm.
They just pop up, shower a little bit, and go away. Hope this one goes away. All right, they're counting them off in the field.
Here's an opportunity for the Hawks to again take another commanding lead. They did pretty good by only giving up two. So if they could match that, it'd be good. I guess their goal would be to go up another six.
Ooh. Bottom of the bat. It's
I don't like that
field.
Hit.
It went by.
It's not going to work for Axel. He's up. Yeah, he's out.
Got him.
That he didn't get too much of that.
Boy, that was a bang bang play. Axel was there.
Oh yeah, he's gonna leg it out if he can.
Uh oh, they're gonna be.
What's happening?
They're checking. They're checking. They're checking with the other umpires. Had a better look maybe. He had to look at one and then look back at the other, and he's down there talking. Little conference. I didn't.
He's safe.
He changed it over.
They turned it around. Yeah. And that's why it's important to have that speed, because no matter if you hit those grounders or not, if you're fast, you get give yourself a chance, man. Wow. The Hawks get a favor there. There's no outs. And they go up 13-9 on a little reverse of the call there for Axel Cox. So we move on to Brandon. Brandon, I think the last hit was awesome.
I tell you, it just looked like that ball went right through that bat. I could not see what. Oh, he hit a good one right up the middle.
There he goes again. Oh, wow. He made a good play.
Yeah, he did. The deep guy got a hold of it. Is Brandon hitting a, is that a wooden bat Brandon's hitting with? It is a wooden bat.
Yeah, he has
a black wooden bat.
A unique wooden bat that says Austin Blackhawks on the bottom engraved in it. And he's an aficionado, man.
That is a very cool looking bat.
Right. Yeah, he showed it to me. It really feels pretty cool. It's definitely wooden.
And the handles get a little fatter at the back of it. You get a better grip with your lead hand.
Right.
All right, here we go. Aaron Mazarego's is up. Right, comes the pitch. Eric gets a piece of it. It's out there in first base side. The spin of the ball kicked it out foul. It went about 41
feet.
It is
now a regulation to tape all the bats because...
Wooden or not, yeah.
Wooden or not. A couple years back, I mean, I was in the league at the time. Chad, what's Chad's last name out of Chicago? He was a pitcher. Chad Perry got an old bat, piece of a bat, broke and went straight into his leg. Took him about a year and a half to get back on his feet. And guess what he's doing? He's pitching. And there's a ground ball. And they got it. Yeah.
That's two outs.
Two outs. Eric Mazarego's got a...
Lupe's up. Number two.
Eric Mazarego's hit a grounder and that just didn't work.
Lupe.
Now batting number two, Lupe Perez.
Still 13-9, two outs, and here we go with Lupe Perez. I think this is it, man. If Lupe wants it, he needs to get it here.
Yeah, he's got to get something here. They did have a two-run or a two-out rally a little bit ago.
Yeah, but so he can. If anybody can get it started, it's him, and he's overdue again. He's got a couple good hits last time, but let's. See if he can do it. Kevin and Lupe have been working together for over 20 years.
Lupe set. Comes the pitch. He hits a deep ball up the middle of the field. It's in the air a long time. Guy's getting in front of it. He's at the base.
There you go.
Oh, man, I tell you what. Both the offense and the defense of this game is amazing. I can't tell you how quickly those plays are being made. It is one step here and one inch there. I'm just absolutely amazed at the way this is going.
Lupe Perez, definitely also another veteran player, but had lots of family before him.
24, Zach Arambula.
24.
Did you ever meet any of Lupe's uncles?
I did not.
Okay, yeah.
Sal Guzman. I should say I did, but not where we was,
right.
You know, introduced. Right. We played against each other, things like that.
Right. And rich beatball history in his family.
Yeah, I met Sal, but it was just in passing.
Right.
All right, he got the top half of the bat. He's working his way down, inch at a time. He's coming down into the bat. That's a good sign.
Zachary right here. I'm going to keep this streak rolling. It's on the ground. Nope. Wait. Ball's out. Yeah, he's out. That's three outs. They were able to get two runs. Make it 14-9.
14-9.
Wow. We're going to go to the top of the fifth, guys. 14-9. Another nail biter.
Going to the top of the fifth inning. Austin 14. Taiwan 9. I can take this opportunity to say thank you again for Grand Athena for putting these championship games out onto the web for all the world to see.
Grammy!
Grand Athena's production studio with play-by-play commentating of Tim Hibner and Richie Flores.
Thank you. Shout out there, Steve. I appreciate that.
Sounds like some of our folks definitely left to go get ready for the banquet. But I know they're streaming.
The Flom Eye Institute.
And,
tell you what, I know that some of you can see it, but Joe.
T-shirts and sweatshirts are still available here at the merchandise table, and as well tonight at the banquet or in the future.
I know that the video feed will show this, but Joe Slatsky's here in front of our table. He's the one that checks the blindfold. He's out there on the field. He has been out here every day in that wheelchair, refereeing and umpiring. He has been a real addition to the umpiring team. That man right there is to me a testament of what somebody can do.
Yes, sir. We are all about inclusion in this game, and really need to see how we can bridge that gap between disabilities.
Did you put 18 or 8? Okay. I think you got it figured out right, though.
Oh, yeah. Here we go. That was a
stroke
good hit.
Down third baseline. Foul ball. Kicked out foul just before the corner.
Wait, who is this batting again? What number is he? Are we back at 35?
No, it's not 35. I think we're down towards 21.
Okay, yeah.
I have to wait till he turns around to make sure.
Yeah, I think you're right. And they're trying to go towards Lupe's side.
Yes, it is 21.
Okay.
Yu Ting Ku.
Took a ball.
He took a ball right there. He walked up. And his timing, you know, he was out in front of it. He wants to know where he's at. So
also, he took a long run to the base and he had a breather, extra.
Oh, it was a good cut right there. Just missed the spot. Leo was just a touch high.
Strike three, here we go. Money pitch, as they say. See what number 21 can do to bring back some life to the Taiwanese.
Okay, here we go. Well, he got a hold of
Sounds
him.
It's down
third baseline again. Oh, it's foul.
Foul. Yep.
Come down. I tell you, sitting under this tent, they just disappear up in the air. You can't tell where they're going to go.
Really cool that, you know, Dave Wanchick also, you can find him on the Beat Baseball Project on Facebook, and he reminded us about Leo and him being a cab driver, and that's a really easy place to meet blind people. And
oh yeah, I would think. Yeah, you're absolutely right. I never really thought about it, but yeah. I'll tell you that in Oklahoma City, the Yellow Cab Company was one of the sponsors.
Right, for Beat Baseball. That's great.
Got a hold of it. It's foul again.
Ball.
It was going down first baseline, and of course the spin on the ball, like a tire, just grabbed it when it hit the ground, grabbed it and moved it to the right. Foul ball. Leo needs to put something up this time.
Yeah, no, they gotta make a run here. This is the inning to do that. No outs here. He strikes him out.
Oh man!
One out. Eh?
One out. We're going to number
52.
Jin
Chang. Now batting number 52. Jin Jang Chang. Two J's and a CH. Boy, without the wind, those sound a lot better, don't they?
Yeah, they do.
I think it just dropped a little early. He's putting the drop on that golf swing and just dropped a little early.
Strike one.
They're talking to him. He's saying something. All right, here they come. Here comes the pitch from Leo. He got a piece of it. Nope, not enough. Not enough. It ain't going.
Work.
Went to the 20 foot. That's about as far as it went. All right, he's relining himself up. It's so important. Line yourself up.
Gosh, yeah.
Yeah, the same way every time.
Strike three. In a good way that blind people do that, they actually bend over and touch the plate with their two hands.
Well,
to make sure.
You know, I think it was Zach or Axel used these toes.
Yep. Some people use the bat. Lots of cool techniques to set yourself up. But
I usually, like for people to lay that bat down and sure they straddle that.
Ooh, two strikeouts.
I like for them to ensure that they straddle at, it's not really a batter's box, but it's a batter's line.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to straddle that batter's line. And I like for them to lay the bat down and straddle that batter's line. And then if I need to fine tune where the ball's dropping into the bat, then I'll slide them 6 inches one way or the other.
Two strikeouts in a row there. That's not the time to be doing that right here.
No.
They got one more out to go. No runs on top of the fifth. 14-9. Second and determining game of the championship here. Wow.
Leo hit a good pitch. I think he was just a hair early.
We're back to 52.
25. Oh, hits a line shot.
Eric. Get it. Got it. Straight. Perfect call for Eric.
Yep, it's
over.
That's Eric's bread and butter.
Yep.
It just about got by him. It was a pretty hard hit.
Yeah.
But he got down. His hip slowed it down. It went. He reached around behind him. Knew it was laying right there. And reached around and got it.
That was not the time to serve up that bagel, as they say.
Yeah. They got a big goose egg for that for that inning, and that's not a good thing. It really.
I just heard it a little while ago. Zach called out, where did Mama keep the bagels? And somebody said top shelf.
So
nobody really knows what that means, but sounds kind of fun all the time.
So here comes a new base. They may have heard me talking. I brought out a whole new base. So.
Oh, bringing a new base. We're going to be bottom of five.
What's coming up to bat then?
Oh, who should be next?
Like Axel is in the batter circle. Number 22.
Now, coming to bat, number 22, Axel Cox.
Yep.
Oh, no. Axel's, it's Mike Finn.
Mike
I'm
Finn.
Sorry.
Apologies. Number 32, Mike Finn.
Axel's in the
on deck
circle. That's correct.
So here we go. They're going to get insurance here. If they can score a couple runs and hold Taiwan to three outs, they will finally be champions again. For real this time. Today.
Do you think there's a asterisk on some of them championships? Taiwan don't show up if you don't beat Taiwan. Do you feel?
Yes. The way Austin handled the extreme last year in both games, we 12-runned them in the first game and then pretty much beat them by 9 runs, I believe. Last year in the finals, and this ain't happening here.
Right, here we go.
Wow.
Mike Finn gets a good hit up the middle. It's right in the sixth zone. It bounces about 120, 130 feet.
He's safe. Wow.
He was halfway to the base before the ball hit the ground. They only had one chance to get it up, and when he grabbed it, he was his hand was on top of it. Mike was touching the base.
Yep, 15-9. This is
they're pulling away. This is a good lead, but again, it was 15-12.
And this is where you run out of gas. You know, the third game, halfway through.
Yeah.
You've been playing and playing and playing to get here.
Mm.
All right, Kevin's up to go.
Axel Cox.
He was a little low on that one.
Yep.
All right, Kevin's looking down the pipe. Axel's using his toe to check the base. He stepped back. He's ready to go.
Mm. Strike two.
He's got a line drive in the six hole. He called a number and the guy moved out of the way. The guy in the outfield gets it up.
Balls it up.
He got
out.
It. He got it up.
Wow. Close.
The call was made and the guy in the center of the field, he went the wrong way, but the guy deep in the field, he went the correct way, traced the ball down, intercepted it, and picked it up just a step before Axel got to the base.
So here we go. One out, 15-9.
At number 30.
Now batting number 30, Brandon Chesser.
I'm telling you what, this is a game of inches today.
Yes.
You know, you have to want that extra inch.
Brandon's done his job today pretty well.
Here comes Kevin. Now he's finally getting this new pitching style. He's finally getting this new pitching style down.
Mm-hmm.
It's not near as hard on his legs.
Right.
And, you know, the balls are being more consistent than they have been in the past. Oh, he's got it up in the air.
Wow. That was nice and high. Ooh.
It's 41 feet.
He's safe. Wow.
That is
right in that corner coffin there, man.
That is one of the first times. It's right in the six. It's right in the middle of the field. But that's one of the first times I've seen the English take it into fair territory. The spin on the ball, literally, when it hit, it spun sideways, and it was 39 feet.
He skied it.
And it took it sideways into the field of play by about 6 inches.
So Eric Mazarillo's, you know, see if he can keep this roll going now. 16-9, bottom of five. Austin Blackhawks can taste it. But they want to make sure that they go down or go to the sixth inning with as big a lead as they can. Wow.
Into the fans.
Ooh.
Everybody got out of the way. Good, good, good. Well, they've only got one more time.
Yep, they only
six.
Yeah, they've got three outs.
That's it. That's all they got left. Kevin gets done here. He's got one more chance if they do catch up and get ahead.
Yep.
But Leo's only got one more chance to make this game.
Yeah, he's going to have to get right now at least 8 runs.
There he comes, looking down the pipe.
Wow.
It's first base side, about the two hole. Oh.
Wow.
He got a good play. That number 25, he got right on it, got on his knee because he knew it was coming to him, and then he shot out to the correct side, the right side, and picked that ball up.
That's a second out.
That is a good play out there deep.
Well, let's see what Lupe can do here.
Number two, Lupe Perez.
Now batting number two, Lupe Perez.
Still at 16-9.
And that ball changed tones, and he still flagged it down. It was that was an amazing play by number 25. You know, he's been trying awful hard out there, but gosh, it's downhill off the crown, and it kind of rolls to the
right
to his left side. You know, and it just it's really hard to judge that ball. But these are the kind of fields you gotta have. You can't have a baseball field, and football fields are crowned also and narrow. So soccer fields is where we play ball. It's what we do.
Yep. Soccer fields is where it's at for beat ball. Gives us the right amount of space and grass all over the place.
All right.
Here we go.
Kevin's back at the 40-foot line. He's looking down the pipe. All right. He's walking up to the pitcher stripe there. He's got his foot on the stripe. Puts the other one down. Oh, Luke.
Strike one.
Luke was a little in front of it. He's anxious.
Yeah. He wants to end this. I know that.
Yeah, let's put a punctuation mark on this thing. He got it up in the air, but it was a foul ball inside the 20 foot. Hit the ground spinning. All right, Luke's ready. He's sitting there too long. Kevin's making him wait too long.
Nice hit on it, but he's safe.
Oh, wow. It's a hard line shot up the center of the field on the first base side. It was a six call. Went over the first guy. The guy in front couldn't even make a play on it. Jumped over the mid-level guy. The deep guy hit him in the chest so hard that it rolled away from him by about 6-7 inches.
Zach Arambula.
Now batting number 24, Zach Arambula.
It hit him in the chest so hard that it rolled 6 inches out of his reach, and he had to get up and move to get the ball, and by that time, Loopy was on the base.
17-9.
This is almost putting it out of reach.
Yeah, they're putting out of reach here. They, yeah, you never know with Taiwan. They're so unpredictable.
Those dogs came down from 6 and 11-10.
Yeah, yep.
Because Tim hitting his pitcher. Well, sometimes the ball rolls to you. Sometimes the ball rolls away.
Here we go. Yeah, if Zach does score, it's going to be pretty hard to make 9 runs. They haven't been able to make more than 3. Yeah, they bageled them a couple times, so. Strike 3. Okay.
You're just under it.
Here we go, guys.
Just ain't quite hitting the spot.
Let's see where we end up after this.
Feel it cool off.
Yes.
The clouds start to shade us.
Wow.
Got a hit. Pop fly.
That sounded
pretty
good.
Drop behind the second guy.
He's safe. Wow. 18-9.
I know you all can hear them hollering in the field, that the up or the out or whatever they call. But a lot of times they'll holler just before they get the ball off the ground. The umpire's letting them know you did not have that ball up, off the ground, off your body. And he'll let them know right then.
Now batting
there.
Number 32, Mike Finn.
They try everything to get a little advantage on the game. And it's not just Taiwan. Everybody does that.
Yeah, I did it a couple times when we played a few people. You just get excited. You know you're going to get it, but.
Yeah, you want him to look at you.
Yes, sir.
You look at you first, and that's what it is. You know, look at me, ump. I got the ball.
Mm-hmm.
And he looks over, he sees you, and then looks over at the runner.
Here we go.
Get his attention is what you want to do.
Michael Finn, he's been pretty money all day.
All right, Michael.
He took a pretty good sized step. I think that caused his bat to be a little lower than normal.
Right.
Small step, big hit, right up the middle of the field. 6 called, and it's hopping around, and they don't get him.
19-9. Yeah, making it bleed now, you know. Austin was determined whether they had that controversial call or not, that they were going to win this game, and they are making a statement right here. Wow. Mixed bag. Wow.
Somebody on the ground out there, I can't tell. Okay, he's up. I don't know what happened.
Yeah, Axel Cox. It's been great.
They've been rolling on too. You know, it's
that's what Austin does.
Yep, Axel was given a run, and
you got it. You got it.
He also took one from him. Yep.
He's on the 40-foot line. Go ahead.
Now batting number 22, Axel Cox.
Both Axel and Zach are from San Antonio, and Kevin's actually in San Antonio now. And they all make the trip out to Austin every couple weeks to have practice between the months of April and August, just to be right here in this position. 3 outs away from a championship. As Austin continues to bat, let's see if they can keep rolling. Oh, like that. No grounder. He's safe.
Oh, wow. Oh, no. I thought different.
This is bang bang.
I can only see one side of it. There's too many people. I couldn't see the base.
And they've hit 20. 20-9. It should be Brandon.
Now batting number 30, Brandon Chesser.
That's I couldn't see all of it, but I thought that was for sure the last out. Sounded kind of sad, didn't it?
Yeah, they're trying to do a rally cry here for the defense to get off the field from Taiwan. Again, Brandon swinging that,
he's swinging
custom wooden bat.
Yeah. He hit the ground. Yeah, he kind of chopped it. He looked like a fella out.
He's out. And
he kind of chopped at it. I don't know anybody else that does that.
Yeah, that's a Richie trademark here. Chop, chop, chop.
The event will start at 9 p.m. tonight at the Radisson Hotel.
So here we go. This is for all the marbles here. 3 outs, and Austin is the 2015 champions. We're at 20-9. This is the second and determining game.
Thank you to all the teams participating this year in the 2015 Leo's Beach
got three,
Baseball
three
World
outs to catch up. He's got to make 11 runs.
11 runs to tie, 12 runs to go up. And then if so, Austin will have to come bat again. And they haven't had any trouble in this game. Wow. Been a long day. We appreciate you guys for hanging in here. We're getting close to the end.
Joe's out there chicken blindfolds.
You could pretty much feel the energy of Taiwan. They are a little down here, but you know they have that quiet. They have that quiet sense about them that you know it's slipping away.
I think Joe had his Little League stuff on. I think he's leaving here and he's going to ump a Little League game or something.
Oh, wow.
Oh, I'm telling you.
He's a busy guy.
Oh, yeah. But he said he just couldn't give up on these guys. He was just so impressed with them.
Yep. He's already planning his trip to Ames. We value the umpires who come every year.
Number 55, top of the order. Top of the
now
order.
Batting number 55 from the Taiwan home run.
Shen Chu. Yeah, someone's up.
So as you remember, I said that I feel like the rain's coming in.
Yes.
Okay.
Temperature's dropping.
Okay. So as I look at the tree line, you can see a difference in color. The leaves turn over, so mm-hmm. they have more pores on the bottom.
Right.
When the sun's shining, they have the darker, less pore side of the leaf showing.
Sure.
And I don't know how or why they know, but they can tell what's coming. Oh, it's in the three hole. Axel got it.
Axel. Man, that was a routine play for Ax.
I thought for sure that the spin of the ball was going to move it over.
And there we go. Two more outs, and Austin will take home the championship second year in a row.
Designated hitter number 9.
And it'll be the feather in their cap. They've been trying to beat Taiwan this championship since the entrance of that team into this league.
Ching Chi Chin, I believe.
And it'll be the 9th championship for Austin if they get 2 more outs. The 9th championship in 40 years. That's pretty amazing. And a dominant, I mean, it's a dynasty that the Blackhawks have created. Definitely in the 90s, and it's looking like it's going to happen. The next few years, they're a force to reckon with.
They're having fun on that bench, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
They taste it.
It's super close here. For Austin to finish this out.
Comes the pitch. He hits a hard shot up the 6 hole. They lined up on it. Oh, they fell the wrong way. Mike didn't quite reach it. It was the 5-6 line.
Right.
I think that went all the way to the road. It was the 5-6 line on the first base side. Mike Finn had to go a long ways. Didn't quite make it to it. And the deep guy is here now. Zach, is that who it is on the first base side? He come across, and it just went right by his feet. He was within 6 inches. Number 35.
Now batting number 35.
This has been some of the best beat ball I've been able to witness in a long time. Pretty much all week, man. This is great.
Well, one thing I like as good as playing beat ball is watching beat ball.
Yes, sir.
Oh, wow. It's a hard shot. They're hitting it. Loopy again. Loopy goes over. It got by him.
He missed the base. Oh, wow. Okay. He's safe.
Unless Loopy's hurt, let's take a look. He just couldn't get to the ball. I mean, it was that hard to hit. He's in anguish over there right now. But there's nothing wrong. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with what he did.
He got
in line. He was lining up with the line of the ball. He went down. It was just moving too fast down that hill on the crown side. He did everything right. And you know, sometimes the ball
rolls to you. Yep.
And sometimes it rolls away.
So.
Number 21.
Number 21, and he's putting it on that good part, man. Leo is putting it where he needs to. But they need 10 more like that to go up. Which is difficult.
Leo's looking down the pipe.
Not impossible. Difficult.
All right, here we go.
Nope, it's on the ground.
It's a grounder. It's going to get past Eric, I think.
Mikey.
And stop between Mike and Luke.
He's safe.
And that's it.
Wow.
It stopped between Mike and Luke.
And they're making some noise here. 20-12. Taiwan.
Even if they don't win it, they're going to prove they were here.
They're going to go down swinging hard.
They're going to make it respectable.
It's a long ride home. You know.
They need more than just they, because Austin's got a chance to come back, get it back at the bat. You know,
not necessarily a ride, a couple flights home. True.
20-12.
There he goes. First pitch
he's
strike.
Swinging hard. He's swinging for the fence.
They're swinging for the fences here. Wow.
He's down the first baseline. It's got a little English on it. He's going to have to. Oh, he's not going to make it. He's not going to make it.
He's safe.
He went over after it. The English just made, the English and the crown just kept making that thing curve away from him. It finally ended up in what we would call foul territory, but it got past the corner, and he just kept chasing it, and it just kept going away.
Here we go. They're making a run here. They're making some noise. We're down to 20-13.
The one that made that put out.
Now batting.
Two outs.
25 for the Taiwan home run.
For Austin to close this out. Okay.
Shay Hu Hound. It's one out, I believe.
Yeah, there's only one out.
Get that ball up. Another interesting thing is Dan Green, the president of the NBBA, he runs the bases, making sure that there's no, it's always random. Slice hit, three hole, over Axel.
Brandon, as Zach gets it, Zach makes a play in deep right to make it 20-13 with only one out to go to close this.
Yeah, we get to set here, but Dan Green, he's right behind the catcher, so he can hear the ball hit the bat, and he turns the base on at just the right time, every time. It's a last thing the president wants is a late base call.
Yep. So, right, here it is, guys.
All right, here we are, 55, top of the order.
Do or die here for Taiwan.
Leo's looking down. He's breathing. Deep breaths.
Ooh.
It's up the middle of the field.
Sounds like it's a Mikey. Safe.
He's safe.
Wow.
He got it. All right, 15-20.
This is what I was talking about before. It's never over with time.
Nope.
Taiwan just keeps on plugging away and plugging away.
Nope.
So 11-run deficit is really nothing.
Yep. Down to six. Now. 20-14, one out.
Just keeps chopping away, you know. They're gonna have to put him out. They can't depend on a strikeout from Leo.
No, he's not gonna do that.
Not under pressure. Oh, look at there. They have pulled a guy out of first base side to put in front of Lupe. I told you they believe out there that they're picking on that side of the field. They have opened up
the
right field, first base side of the field. They have two people over there and nobody on the line.
Let's see what
they're going to give Loopy the help that he deserves over there, I guess.
Well, they want to win it. They want to end this now. I'm going to go home, take a shower, celebrate. Turn on some country music. You know, go to that banquet, shave, showered. Happy. I mean, we've been there.
I think he's shooting for that open hole.
Yeah, Austin's been there where.
I think Leo's pushing to get it around on that open hole. He was way out in front of that, and he kind of floated that ball around there. If he'd have got a piece of that, it'd have went down that first base side. Leo's working it. Told you, there it goes.
There it goes.
First base side. It got by him. Wow. There is nobody back
there. Nobody there.
No.
That's amazing.
He did it.
That's amazing.
He did exactly what I said he was going to do.
Yeah.
They loaded up this side. He went that way.
Maybe we can get Leo there to update the Frank Matina pitcher's guide or approve it or just show that he has studied that. But my goodness.
You can change the timing. Just all it takes is about 6 inches of timing change. And he did it.
20-15. They are excited.
Yeah, they tried to give Loopy some help over there. He'd been hitting it there all day. And as soon as they vacated a part of the field, Leo put it right in that part of the field where it's vacated.
That's pretty amazing. There's talented beatball players.
That's what I would do if it was me. That one year, that three of those hits, I dropped it right in on top of the two people that run into each other.
Right.
It made them tentative. They didn't hurt. They hurt themselves, but they didn't want to get hurt either.
Having a great pitcher on your team is critical to winning.
Yeah, he didn't get here by him. Yes.
Okay.
Now they're going back to that other side.
Yes.
Wow. Up the middle of the field to six. Mike Finn. Over Mike Finn.
Oh. It's the ball is up. 2015 World Series beat ball champions, Austin Blackhawks. Who made that put out?
Oh, we have a pile in the middle of the field.
They're
all piling on.
Wow.
This looks like a big league win, man.
They earned it.
They are stacking them up on top of each other in the middle of the field.
We'll bring in another championship home to Texas. 2 years in a row.
Congratulations to the 2015 Beat Baseball
Congratulations to
the Austin Blackhawks.
All members and players for the Blackhawks, they're volunteers.
They're all stacked up out in the middle of the field there.
This has been a very stressful and competitive two games between these teams. The final score is 20-15. Perfect score for the 2015 World Series championship.
Wow, what a number. 2015,
yeah.
Yep.
Thank you to Tim Hibner and Richie Flores for doing the play-by-play and color commentating here today. Thank you to Graham Mathena for doing all the production work. These feeds will still be up and viewable, and then we will have those also available for the NBBA website.
Get your pet spayed and neutered. And we'll see you next time.
Pet Savers.
Pet Savers. Good
thank
job.
You to the,
love your NBBA world.
Thank you to David and Eileen Flom from the Flom Eye Institute here in Rochester, New York, as well as ABBI here in Rochester, New York, and the Monroe County Sports Commission.
Get ready, jukebox. Country music coming to the bar.
Thank you again to everyone watching all over the world to the 2015 Beat Baseball World Series Championship Games between Austin Blackhawks and Taiwan Home Run. As Richie just said, your champions are the 2015 Austin Blackhawks.
Beautiful stuff.
All right, they're getting ready to shake hands.
Wow.
Now, those are two hungry teams that played two.
They will, and as Taiwan usually does, they will hug each other and hug the opposite team, and they will take pictures with them. And it is our hope to see both Taiwan teams here next year. They can give it a run.
Beat Baseball World Series.
And this is the NBBA 2015 World Series Championship call. Signing off.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you all for being here. I tell you, it was amazing.
Wow.
Man, Richie, that was a heck of a game, man. You like that right there? Man.
Wow.
Beautiful stuff.
Yes, ma'am. Who's tall?
Love hearing you talk about stuff, man.
Where are you?
I'm crazy, ain't I?